Alright, there we go. Oh, I'm silly. I can't believe I hit the wrong button to stream. I had it set to my option of the recording, not the streaming. So if there was a little bit of a difference, it should be good now. Well, this is not that much of a little cutoff anyways. Alright, now we gotta do stuff with the musical score. It revolves going downstairs from the hallway down there. Hopefully a zombie doesn't pass through it. I really don't want there to be a zombie. Alright. Alright. Through the spooky door. Alright, let me check one little itty bitty thing. Before I forget. Anyone out there, by the way? Hello? You know, give me a little message if someone's out there. Anyone? Hello? Anyone there? Expensive looking grand piano. There we go. Alright. Whoa, what?
It's me, Chris. Oh, yeah.
Hey, Rebecca, what's up? Oh, hi. Hello, analyst duelist. Sonata. Welcome to the stream.
Can you play?
Just started about like 10 minutes ago, so it's not much you would have missed. To be fair, she plays a lot better than I would ever play on the piano.
My interpretation is off a little.
Off? That's not that bad. For a while. Sure.
Sure. But don't get too carried away.
Oh, I won't.
Alright, it's very important that you let Rebecca practice. I think after a little while of time, she'll actually be able to play Moonlight Sonata on her own. I'm not sure how long it takes for her to, like, be able to play it properly. Oh. Ooh, I didn't like the sound of that. Zombies would have probably gone through the door. I think if you let her practice for a little while, she should be able to play it properly. I'm not sure how long the requirement is for it. Let's see. Switch that for that, and I get a second item for that. Alright. I think I will need the shotgun, and I might need the kerosene. But do I really want to go get the kerosene? That area is dangerous to go through with the one zombie down there, so I'll have to take the alternate path. But I do need a little bit of time to pass in order for Rebecca to be able to play Moonlight Sonata properly, is the only thing. Alright, well, let's just go get the kerosene. Hopefully that'll be enough time for Rebecca to be able to play Moonlight Sonata. Just gotta wait for old Bob to get over here first. Okay. So that's enough distance. That should be enough distance. Yeah, he's good. It is good. Let us go. Because on the way back, that zombie might just burst through the door, and I don't really want that area to be compromised. Alright. Alright. Sounds like laundry. Huh. Kerosene. I don't need the shotgun shells. I need the inventory for it. The next thing. Alright. Oh, we got the kerosene, just in case we have to deal with that one zombie in the hallway where the piano is. Oh, Bob. I feel bad for Bob sometimes. All he wants is just some brains, and he's gonna just starve for the rest of his undead life. Alright. Anyways, by now, hopefully Rebecca would have learned how to play Moonlight Sonata so we can get rid of this puzzle out of the way. Also, I really hope that one zombie doesn't burst through the door, because I also don't want to waste the ammo. Alright. Oh, you saw that. I don't know if you guys saw that, but it looks like that door was just about to get busted down. That was pretty close, at least.
Chris, I think I got it.
Hey. I wish I could play the piano. Perfect. I wish I could play the piano as just as good, yes. But I'm not very good at piano. I can only play the electric bass. Alright, thanks, Rebecca. Anyways, little thing over here. Trevor's diary. November 24th. 11 days have passed since I arrived on this estate. How did I end up like this? A guy in a lab coat brought me a meager plate of food and said, "Sorry to put you through this, but it's for security reasons." That's when it hit me. It all makes sense now. There are only two people that know the secret of this mansion, Sir Spencer and myself. If they kill me, Sir Spencer will be the only person that knows the secret. But for what purpose? It doesn't matter now. It's too dangerous here. My family, I hope they're alright. I have decided to escape. Lisa, Jessica, I pray for your safety. November 26th. How could I be so careless? I lost my favorite lighter, the one Jessica gave me for my birthday. Now it's going to be much harder to escape this dark place. November 13th, the date when my fate was sealed. My aunt was hospitalized just 3 days before that. Jessica and Lisa said they were going to visit her. I wish I could be there with them. But wait, even as I'm writing, my memory is coming back to me more vividly. Just before I passed out, I remember the man in the lab coat said something like, "Most likely your family is already blank. I pray for their safety." November 27th. Somehow I managed to get out of that room, but getting out of this mansion won't be as easy. I have to get past all the booby traps. Tiger Eyes, Gold Emblem. I have to try to remember them for my own sake. A little bit of backstory on Trevor. There's like bits of backstory for him, like around the mansion. Anyways, we want to take this, which will cause that wall to close. And it'll be like, oh no, we're trapped. Thankfully, we just got to use this poopy little wood emblem, and then it'll just open up. And now we're free. I don't know if Rebecca has anything to say. If I can get there, you go.
Were you all right in there?
Yeah.
Okay. That was the most odd little dialogue, but sure. All right. I think Rebecca will just, like, teleport to the, Oh god. I hate when that door rattles. It spooks me a little bit sometimes. Because I'm like, oh boy, I hope that zombie doesn't burst through the doors. But yeah. Anyways, now that we've got the gold emblem, we can just go over here and replace it. There. Which then opens a secret compartment that grandfather cocked to the gearbox. Anyways, important to note, you gotta check this painting for this part of the secret of the puzzle. A picture of two knights striking each other. The short sword has been thrust into the breast of one knight, while the long sword has been pierced into the head of the other. Anyways, this puzzle isn't that very difficult. When two have run each other through, the path to your destiny will open. Looks like you can turn the gears inside the claw. Try it, yes. And I think you have to turn the large one. It doesn't really matter which direction, left or right, as long as you turn it twice. And that's it. Just gotta set to, like, 6 o'clock. And for some reason, that clock moves a little bit on its own, and then we get a mansion key. Not just any mansion key. We get the shield key. Very nice. So that is key number 3, I think? Yeah, sword, armor, and then shield. So that means we got 3 of the 4 keys of the mansion. Besides a different other key, but that's until later. Alright, before I go do what must be done, I'm gonna go stock up. Make sure I'm ready for what's gonna happen. Alright. Wait for Bob just a little bit. There we go, that should be enough. Alright. Let's go get some shotgun shells. The ones that we have left in the box. And a green herb just for good measure. Probably might leave the handgun ammo behind. Alright, and Rebecca just, you know, teleports here.
Want me to treat your wounds?
Because she has, like, awesome powers. Alright, we don't need the handgun ammo, but we will need the shotgun. Oh. I don't think we'll need the kerosene, actually, so we'll actually leave that behind and take the shotgun shells, and then I'll take the green herb, just in case. I'm gonna take a little sip of drink. I need a throat's feeling a little bit parched. Let me put that over here. Alright, much better. Alright. Now we got everything we need. Take care of the next little bit. Because now we're going to use that shield key. Get into that one room we couldn't get to a moment ago. Alright. Oh, whoa. Don't get stuck in a wall, Chris. Alright. Alright. Hopefully a certain zombie's not right in front of the door. I would be a little bit sad if he is. No, there he is. Alright, let's just dodge him. What was that? What was that? That was strange. Something just happened. That was the strangest thing. Oh, whatever. Alright. Shield key only has one use, so we'll have one more inventory slot at least. I really hope I have the ammo to do this, though. Because if you don't know, we're going to have to deal with a boss pretty soon, and I don't think there's any other stuff we can get here, except for one item. Oh, wait, there is something here. Shotgun shells! Nice! Those will come in handy. There's still one more thing we gotta get, and actually take out the shotgun. Because it's a snake! Hello, everyone. I hope you don't have a fear of snakes, because we're going to fight a snake known as Yawn. Kind of got me stuck. There you go. Run, run, Chris. Don't get stuck on the stupid snake. Take this. That's the final death mask we need. Gotta kite him. Whew! A little close. Don't want to get hit by that stupid snake. Damn it. Couldn't aim properly. Oh crap, time to reload, of course. Oh god, I hate when I get stuck on his stupid tail. Ow, ow, ow. Okay, what's my health at? Yellow. Not good, not good. Let me heal up, because I'm gonna need the health. Oh god, he's still mad. What is he doing? Music stopped. He's still pissed? Oh no, he's leaving now. That kind of sucked, because I'm poisoned. Balls. Kind of got stuck on the stupid support beam. Poison sucks.
Chris!
I need serum.
Serum? I remember seeing it. I'll be right back. Just hang in there.
Alright, we don't got much time, fortunately. Only got like 3 minutes to like save Chris, otherwise I think we get a game over for that. Alright. Right. And this is probably the one of the few times you actually get to play as Rebecca too, which is really nice. Alright, gotta hurry though. Don't want to get stuck in any walls. I think Rebecca has her pistol, one clip of ammo, and a first aid spray. Usually the best thing to do is like to clear out the enemies along the way so you don't get ambushed into unwanted situations. I don't know if loady doors count towards your time limit, but I don't think they do. Don't want to get stuck in a wall, that would be terrible. There we go. Whew, that was a little bit close. I think I should have enough time if I hurry. Alright, serum. Okay, she only has the gun with 15 bullets and the first aid spray. And I don't think Rebecca can put her items in the item box. It'll be like a separate character item box. You can't like store the first aid spray or the gun for Chris to use, which would be a little bit... it wouldn't be too unfair to have like a second pistol and an extra first aid spray, but I think they wanted to let her have her own unique items. What was that warning? Alright. Now then, we just gotta go take the serum back to Chris. Hopefully I have enough time to do this. Hello, WT Smithy 07. Welcome to the stream. Hope you'll enjoy the time we had here. We just fought a very mean, angry snake and got poisoned by it. Because, you know, snakes are jerks. Nobody likes giant snakes that bite you and poison you. Because they're really mean. Just gotta watch out for the one zombie here. Yeah, those snakes are pretty angry. I don't know why the snake has to be really salty. I think we made it just in time, though.
How are you feeling?
What happened?
You were bitten by a poisonous snake and fell unconscious. Easy.
Oh, hello, Luca. Lucas Coda 888. Welcome to the stream.
It's killing me.
You should be fine, because I gave you a shot of serum. But again, don't do anything...
That you wouldn't do? I'll try to remember that. I owe you one.
Alright, thanks, Rebecca. I got an achievement. Nice. And I still got the things to take care of. And, didn't lose the health.
Oh, thank God I made it in time.
Yeah, that would have been pretty bad if you didn't make it in time, but we did. Looks like 18 are viewing. Why is nobody talking? I don't know. Maybe people aren't just that chatty. Alright, let's just watch out for you, and... And now... Oh, I just realized we got the last death mask. Oh boy. I just realized that now. What's our ammo situation? 9 shotgun shells. Well, hopefully that should be enough for what we're about to do. It should be enough. Alright. This part is going to be hopefully either really good or really bad. Really hoping I'm really good, because if it's really bad, that's not gonna be fun. Alright. Death mask without a nose. Oh boy, not looking forward to this. Oh yeah. Jesus Christ. Oh boy. There should be some shotgun shells to there, but I don't think they will let us get it. Nope. Cutscene. Hello, Crimson Head prototype number 1. You are not a fun person. Just wait for it. Alright, 3 shotgun shells. So only took 3 shotgun shells. Nice. I was pretty lucky too. He didn't get a hit off on me. I was honestly certain that he would have hit me at least once. I was pretty close. I got pretty lucky that he stuttered. Alright, open that up and then we get another thing. A stone and metal object. Nice. Not just any object. Alright. The emblem is carved on an octagonal object. Alright. Crimson Head is dead. And that is the reason why the two zombies in the graveyard up here do not turn into Crimson Heads. Because, yeah, you have to deal with the Crimson Head boss. So those are the only two zombies that spawn here in the game where they do not turn into Crimson Heads. Which is nice. Everywhere else, they'll, you know, turn. Alright, where was I? Oh, I have to go the other way. I have to think for a minute. Actually, probably going to the item box wouldn't be a bad idea right about now. I just need to assess the situation and what to get. Because now we can go into another area of the game. For those of you that don't know, I don't want to spoil either. Spooky? Where? TV's Adam West! Alright. Go back to the save room. Probably get an item and, yeah, that'll be it. I think we got that item right. I think? Or am I missing that one item?
Are you?
No, I'm okay. But if something should happen to me, I'm counting on you.
No problem.
Oh.
You're very short on medical supplies, so.
Oh, that's what you meant, yourself. Smitty. Yeah, it wouldn't be nice if he were here to just get us out of here, but that's a whole different story, I suppose. Oh, I'm missing that item! Oh, I didn't go there, did I? No, I didn't go there. I gotta go there. I forgot all about that room. Oh boy, I forgot all about that room. I gotta go to that room on the right side of the mansion. I forgot all about that. So I guess for now I'll just dump off the stone and metal object and take the kerosene, because might need the kerosene. It probably wouldn't make much for a game. And just get everyone out of here and then there you go. Just like all the zombies would just like be dead again and then huzzah, everything's good. Of course it would make it too easy. Why would you want to do things the easy way when you can do it the hard way? Alright. Anyways, before we go into that new area, I need to go to the room on the right side of the mansion that I completely forgot about. I thought I did that, but I know I did that on my YouTube channel's Jill playthrough. I did that on Jill's story when I was recording it for YouTube, but not on here, for the stream. That's the thing I'm missing. Although the one bad thing is that zombie's probably gonna burst through the door. Oh yeah, he got through. Crap. I heard him go through that door. Well, damn. Alright, this is the room I forgot to go check. I could juke him, but usually I like to have like those two corridors on the both sides of the mansion zombie free, so I don't have to have the area compromised. And there should be. Oh, I guess you can't investigate that as Chris. It's locked. An old fashioned lock that requires that's rather simple a mechanic. So I'm gonna need an old key. Also, I'm gonna need some space in my inventory too. Hopefully there's an old key on the other side of that room, because I'm gonna need it. Can't believe I forgot all about this door here. Alright. Gotta go dump off some items and actually do some combining too. That should be the same note Wesker left us, right? Mm-hmm. All right. All right. Gonna switch out for the green herb, combine the two, and there we go. Beautiful red-green mixture. Probably huff that green later. Actually, I'll probably put the kerosene in here for the moment. Because there should be a few items we can get there. Hopefully I have the... Well, I probably should put away the shot. Ah, whatever. Put the shot. I'll put like two items away so we can get all the items there. There should be like three items we can get. And you know what? I'll just put the handgun ammo in there, just a good measure. Take another sip of some tea. Nothing better than some good lemon tea. Spooky room, spooky music, spooky deer with antlers, reindeer. Alright. I never had sweet tea. We only have like lemon tea. I've tried green tea. It's okay. Oh hey, what do you know? There's that little key we need. Conveniently enough. And then there should be some ink ribbons here. And there should be one last item, right? Which is the green herb. And that should be everything in this room. Yeah. And then that should be a first aid spray. Alright. Sweet iced tea is the greatest. I never had sweet tea, so... So I wouldn't know if that's any good. Team Green. Alright. I haven't had green tea in a long time, though. It's been like a couple of years. There used to be this girl back in high school that I knew who loved green tea, and I decided to give it a try, and it was okay. She was really great at the piano. Fortunately, I had to transfer schools, which kind of sucked. She was kind of cute, too. She was like a... She was a junior, and I was a sophomore at the time. Researcher's will. There's a letter. June 3rd. My dearest Alma, let me apologize for not being able to call you. A man wears sunglasses and can't permit any phone calls. Sorry, Alma. I'm sitting here trying to think where to begin of how to explain the few simple words all that's happened in my life since we last spoke, and I've already failed. Hope this letter finds you well and that you forgive me for the tangents of my pen. This isn't easy for me. Even though as I write, I feel the simplest concept slipping away, losing feelings of despair and confusion, but I have to tell you what my heart before I can rest. Alma, please believe what I am telling you is the truth. The entire story will take hours for me to tell you, and the time is short, so accept these things as fact. Last month there was an accident in the lab, and the virus we were studying leaked. My colleagues who were infected are dying, or dead or dying, and the nature of the disease is such that those living have lost their senses. The virus robs its victims of their humanity, forcing them in their sickness to seek out and destroy life. Bambi. Hello, Master Zed of Nowhere. Welcome to the stream. We haven't been eaten by zombies or gotten our faces ripped off by dogs, so it's good. Cute and companion panel. Yeah, it is a good combo. I can't remember her name, though. It's been a long time. The virus robs its victim of their humanity, forcing them and their sickness to seek out and destroy life. Even as I write these words, I can hear them pressing against my door like mindless, hungry animals. Alma, I have tried to survive only to see you again, but my efforts are only delaying the inevitable. I am infected. There is no cure for what will follow except for the end of my life before I lose the only thing that separates me from them, my love for you. In an hour, I have entered my internal state where there is peace. Please understand. Please know that I am sorry, Art Crackhorn. Not just yet, yeah. Canada. Cool. Anyways. Fish hook. Various fish hooks. I have a friend who's from Canada. He's studying, like, business and law. Oh, I'm not from Canada. I'm here from California, if you're wondering. Don't want to press that just yet. I actually want to combine these two to make the fish more... or shaped like a bee with a hook attached. Alright. I've never really been out of California, so I don't really know much about the other states. I've only been through Arizona, New Mexico, and Texas. That's about it. I've never been anywhere else. Washington myself. Neat! One day I plan to travel. Once I have the money, I probably travel someday. That's pretty cool. Texan Albanian. That's awesome. Alright. Open this up, and then we get a wind crest. But not before the bees! I don't like the bees! Damn, good job, Chris. Get out of here, I don't like bees! Alberta is the kind of like the Texas of Canada for some reason. Oh, I would have never known. Crude oil, cool. One day off in the sunset, maybe. Indeed. One day in a probably far future I will travel the lands of the world that we live in. Alright, got some ink ribbons, which is nice. Got a first aid spray, which we'll probably never use. Take that stone and metal object. Take the... take the shotgun and take the shotgun shells. I'm gonna need some shotgun shells for this next bit. Alright. Oh, wait. Did I put the wind crest away? Or did I take the wind crest? I forgot. I think I took the wind crest, right? I wasn't dumb, I forgot it, right? So I'm gonna need that. Oh. Well then. I did forget the wind crest. Well, I'm so smart, folks. Go me. Goes in there, does the puzzle, attacks a bee to get the wind crest, doesn't pick up the wind crest. Story of my life. I don't really want to deal with the bee. I don't like bees. Bees are mean. Bees are really mean. Ugh! Bees! Take the wind crest. Oh god. Oh, I was close. I thought I got stung. I'm not really into, like, I don't really know much about that, to be honest. Alright, I got the wind crest this time. Ah. Alright. I think we got everything we need, but... I don't think I'm gonna need any bullets for the time being. As in, pistol bullets. I'll need that for the space. Yeah. I personally don't want to deal with politics. My friend from Canada, he knows a lot of politics, but yeah. Doorknob is broken. Oh yeah. Can't go that way. Gotta go the other way. Gotta go the long way with Salty Zombie. Oh boy, I gotta deal with Salty Zombie. So you one zombie along the way, and then I don't know what else. Gonna need the kerosene unless I'm lucky and get one headshot. But I am gonna need some inventory space. Wow, that's messed up. That's really messed up, Luca. I'm sorry about the stuff that's going on over there. Oh yeah, I left the bullets behind. Okay, let's gotta wait for this. You know, I prefer to kill him than juke him, to be honest, because I'm gonna be traveling through this. Where is he? There he is. Dude, can you not? Seriously. Yeah, that didn't. Yeah, I thought that would. I kinda was hoping for a headshot. That sucks, man. Sorry. Alright, I'm actually gonna dump off a few things because I need the inventory space. Dump off the... I'm gonna need the shotgun, but I am gonna need a few items. Well, I guess it's better to be close to out of debt than being really deep in debt like the states are. Well, I don't really want to talk about politics that much. I don't really like to talk about politics because there's always so many people who are salty on politics, and that's why I usually try to mind my own business on the matter. Okay, we're gonna get rid of one item, and then we're gonna get a second item. I like how this changed from hoping to not get eaten by zombies to politics for some reason. Not to be offensive, but, you know, different change of pace, I suppose. Religion, politics, always, yeah. Studying French? That's fine. I know a tiny bit of French myself, but probably should study some myself. I knew one girl that spoke French, but yeah. That is true. Then again, isn't usually the case of like higher ups would try to hush the media and some things? Oh, I just realized there's a zombie right here. Welp. Here's to hoping I can get a headshot. Wait, why is he right here? Don't. Well, that sucked. I don't want to go back to get the kerosene, but I gotta. I seem to know a lot of girls who know piano and can speak French. Well, everyone has a different story, I suppose. I need to move to California is nice. The only good thing about that's going on right here is that we don't get snow. If you're in like the middle of the states, like in the Bay Area where I am, like a little bit, I live near Sacramento, like a few cities away, and we never get snow in California. Maybe the occasional hail, but it only hailed from my memory. It's only hailed in California like three times of all the time I can remember. Also, I'm going the long way. I just realized I'm going the long way. Well, we still got an hour left of the stream anyways. Northern California? Well, it depends on the... Oh, hello, Saucy King. Welcome to the stream. Yes, this is the HD remake of Resident Evil 1 for Steam. Resident Evil 0 is going to be... remade, and it's going to be available on January 22nd for Steam. Yeah, sometimes the stream quality, hopefully the internet's not being picky. The internet was being a little bit picky a bit earlier, so that's why I couldn't stream like around 8:15, which I was originally going to do. The internet was being a little iffy. So that makes Resident Evil 2 and 0... Yeah, I don't know when Resident Evil 2 is going to be released, but I know Resident Evil 0 is going to be on January 22nd, I'm pretty sure. The only downside, which kind of makes me a little sad, is I don't think Resident Evil 0 Remaster is going to have multiplayer. That's the only thing that's... That's the only downside with Resident Evil 0 Remaster. It's not going to have multiplayer. You'd think it would. They're two playable characters, and they both can use weapons and everything. So you'd think they should be able to put multiplayer, but unfortunately they're not. I don't know. Maybe they might? I don't know. It's up in airs at the moment. I do know they're going to put some a new mode or two or some stuff, and I think DLC. And I think they kept Rebecca's model faithful, except for they added rosier cheeks for her. I mean, honestly, it would be sick to play Resident Evil 0 with multiplayer. I mean, the game is pretty much set up, like, it could be properly set up to use multiplayer. Alright, let's take care of you. There. Because I don't really want to come back through here after a while and then have a crimson head right in my face. Because nobody wants a crimson head in their face. I can tell you that much. Chris doesn't like crimson heads getting in their face. In his face. Just as much as the Crimson Heads don't like getting shotgun rain in their faces. But we don't care about Crimson Heads. Get the modders? Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if somebody would be able to mod Resident Evil 0 on day one. Sure, why not? I'm going the wrong way. I gotta go this way to get the kerosene refilled, dump off some items, and then finally move on to the next area. Alright, my ammunition is okay, but it could be better, to be honest. If I didn't have to deal with that one zombie. Alright. Just gonna get the last bit of kerosene, put it away, and then we should be good to go. Because I don't want to forget getting kerosene. Alright. There we go. Alright, that takes care of everything now. Now, up until this point, I remembered everything that we've done just so far. Because I've never actually beaten Chris's story, so after going to the next area, this is pretty much, in a sense, blind for the most part. Because I don't know where stuff's gonna be, I don't know what's gonna be too different. I'll just skip all those cutscenes. So I'm gonna be a little bit in the dark now. I know I'm not going to need the fuel canister for now. I am going to need the stone and metal object, and I really am going to need the wind crest. Alright, we're good to go. And in case we find some salty enemies, we got a nice little shotgun surprise for them. In the form of some shotgun rain. Still gonna have to be a little bit sparing on shotgun rain. Take a quick drink. Probably might have to save it too. I haven't saved in a little while, or at all, during the stream. But I think I'm in a good enough situation to not worry about saving. For the moment. And then something bad happens and then I have to start all over. That would make me very sad. I would be a very sad person if that happened. Alright, finally. Alright. Get the old and shotgun ready in case if something salty comes through into this area. Alright. Oh, yeah, I heard it. Salty dog. There's a salty dog in here. He's not very nice. Where is he? Hoo-hoo-hoo. Okay, that was pretty close. Ow, ow, ow. Alright. Salty dogs are mean. Salty dogs hurt. He has a bad doggy. Fido is mean. Fido is a really mean dog. Hello, Travis Cleveland 14. Welcome to the chat. Hope you enjoy this day. I thought I was gonna get like the shot in, but he got me at the last second. Sorted tools, and I went through the door. I don't like that first aid spray because sometimes the grab detection is a little bit off. Alright. First aid spray, which we'll never use, and more importantly, a nice little flash grenade. And that should be everything in this area. Yeah, nobody likes salty dogs. Salty dogs are mean. Alright. Anyways, we got a little bit of a puzzle coming up here. Valley of Destruction, Cavern of Hatred, Summon of Madness, Pact of Revenge. Should be a pretty easy puzzle. But these little... I forget what these things are called. Just gotta wait for it, and... there we go. Really easy puzzle. Gotta set this to west. And then the other one to north. Alright. Wesker? I think the conversation with Jill that happens there is a little bit better than what happens with Chris. Alright. I goofed. I done goofed, everyone. Sorry. Alright. There we go. And what? I thought that was right. I thought it was like north and west. Oh, I had the other one set to west. This should be on north. Salty dogs with butter and garlic. Ugh. I know there are people out there that eat dog, but that's just a little bit messed up in my opinion. Like, I probably would never eat a dog, to be honest. Much less an infected dog. And what's just as bad as salty dogs? Salty birds. Or in this case, salty crows. Ugh. I hate crows, are mean. Don't want to upset the crows. There we go. Alright, this is where we use Yield and Windcrest. Which we get more crests. Alright. Crests are fitted in. Take the Boon Crest. Which kind of looks like Moon Man from the old McDonald's commercials. Take the Star Crest. Don't get an inventory space. Alright. Push this, and then these two little things become an equal sign. Hello, Felipe Mango. What's up? Welcome to the stream, and what are you FTFing about? Alright. Anyways, pretty simple. Just gotta... not necessary. What do you mean it's not necessary? Do I have to investigate it first? Alright. Alright, that's one. And that's two. And then we gotta take the last crest. The Sun Crest. Which to me always kind of reminds me of the old Coca-Cola sun. Does anyone remember the old Coca-Cola logo with the happy sun drinking the soda for Coca-Cola? I wonder if anyone remembers that still. Anyways, with all three crests in place, we get a free gun. Well, not just any gun. A freaking magnum. Now we are playing with fire. Aw, isn't that beautiful? Load it with magnum rounds. They usually polar bears? Oh yeah, they have like the polar bears like Christmas time. Since it almost is Christmas time. Well, depending if you celebrate it or not. That time of year where they'll have like like the polar bears or Santa Claus drinking Coca-Cola. Maybe I'm just that old. I'm only 25, I'm not that old. Ooh. I hear the true essence of salt. And the most unnecessary thing in the game. Just this random statue that has absolutely no meaning or value. It's funny that we're just intentionally going into the woods while like Wesker's like, "Don't go into the woods! Why are you doing the exact opposite?" Because we're rebellious bastards, I suppose. Anyways. Cabin in the Woods has nothing to do with that movie, but yeah, let's go in. Surely there's nothing gonna be in here. That's bad, right? All right. Really hope that okay. This fireplace looks fresh. Number of bandages have been hung up. Could these brown stains be blood? And then there should be this. Perfect. Free map. Alright. We got a map. And then there should be something here. There it is. Family picture. There's a journal left by someone. 19th. Daddy attached first, mom attached second. Inside red and slimy, white and hard. Not true, mom. Where? Don't know dad. Found mom again. When attached mommy, she moved no more. She's screaming. Why? Just want to be with her. 4. Mom, where? I miss you. It's like pretty sad. What? Okay, what was up with that stop? That was odd. It's like a random stop in the... It's just like a random stop there. That was odd. I thought I triggered something for a moment. Alright, we're gonna put the magnum away. We're not gonna need that. It's not... It's Coco? Alright. Anyways, we got a crank, but just... Not just any crank, a swear crank. Oh, how Resident Evil loves its cranks. And that's everything in here. Gonna need this crank, and I probably might need something else. Let me think for a minute. Don't really need anything else that I can think of. No. In fact, I think we're good. Oh, wait. I'm gonna take some ink ribbons and save. It's been a little while. Oh. Old typewriter, save my progress. Yes, I'll save my progress. Alright. Took a save, put the ink ribbons back. And let's go. I'm sure that sound was nothing. I'm sure it was nothing at all. Got donkey punched. I don't know about you guys, but I feel bad for Chris. Nobody wants to get donkey punched like that. Also, say hello everyone to Lisa. She is really scary and really salty. And she is like the epitome of salt. She's like the queen of salt right here. Anyways. Okay, that took 2 shotgun shells. It usually takes 1. And now we leave. And we never come back here. And not get stuck in walls. Must have not been close enough for her to stutter like that. Don't know if you answered this, but thoughts on 5 and 6. Well, people have mixed feelings about, like, 5 and 6. I mean, they're a little bit different. Sure, they're a little bit more action-y. Oh, what was that? It was a zombie somewhere. Okay. Whew, that was close. Did you see the juke there? That was a beautiful juke. I honestly thought he grabbed me. Alright. Where was I? Thoughts about 5 and 6. Well, I'll be honest, as a fan of Resident Evil, it wasn't that bad, but I think fans were expecting them to bring back the old style of Resident Evil. I mean, it's nice that we have a Resident Evil with multiplayer, but I think they could have done something better, because, like, I guess the one gripe, in my opinion, with I have about Resident Evil 5 and 6 is that you can't backtrack. You pretty much have sort of a linear path. Whereas, like, Resident Evil, like the Resident Evils before that, you do backtrack. There's backtracking, but there's usually, like an area that you know that you can go to, and then you know you can go to later once you get another item. 5 and 6 are, you know, more linear than the predecessors before that. But then we got Resident Evil Revelations and Revelations 2. Revelations and Revelations Evil 2 kind of are a mix of old and new, but sort of for the better, in my opinion. For the most part, it is sort of linear. I mean, all the games are linear, but you know. It does feel more Resident Evil-y, the old games, than the new ones. But, you know, Revelations 2, but, like 5 and 6 would just hand you ammo. Oh, you gotta go, Master Zed? Alright, take it easy.
Brad! This is Chris! Brad!
God damn it.
Thing's broken.
God damn it, Brad Vickers. Also, there are some salty dogs in here. And there are like 3 salty dogs, if I remember. I've only beaten Leon's campaign for Resident Evil 6. I've beaten Resident Evil 5. With the exception for the DLC that came with it. There was like 2 DLC packs that came with Resident Evil 5, and I'd never done those. Because I don't know, actually. There's just salty dogs. Oh, I can't tell if he sees me. Oh, he sees me. He's going to walk into my path. He's going to see me. Oh yeah, he saw me. Not today, dogs. Alright. Cost a little bit of ammo, but the salty dogs are taken care of, guys. Not getting my face eaten off, or my wrist eaten off by a salty dog. Alright, new item. Blue herbs. I don't think it does... not supposed to... there we go. Mixed herbs. Anyways, blue herbs are different than all the other herbs. They don't heal you, but... they cure poison, so if we ever get poisoned by anything, just huff a blue herb and you're good to go. And so there are only 2 dogs in here. Okay, I'll actually take 2 dogs instead of 3 dogs, because 3 dogs means more ammo to waste. Alright, pretty much good to go now. And not used here, okay. Probably guess I wasn't close enough. There you go. Open this, and that should open the floodgate, and we get some really old CG from the GameCube. I think they actually kept the CG that was in the GameCube version, and they just put it in this game. You can hear the sounds of a waterfall in the distance. That'll be important for later. Anyways, now that we've emptied out this really nasty looking pool, we can actually go to the other side now. Alright. And then we can just go down this little elevator. Take a quick drink. And there are some salty birds. And is there anything here? No. I don't know if there's a salty dog in here as well, but... you don't want to walk too close to the crows, because they get really mean. And they get really angry. Raging waterfall. Looks like there's something beyond it. Oh, hey, June! What's up, man? You missed a lot! Welcome back. How you been, June? We have encountered a few salty enemies, some salty dogs, but we're still good and kicking. We haven't died, at least, which is the best part. And then blue, green, red herbs. Also snakes. Mini snakes. Mini snakes are mean, because they bite you and they poison you. And we finally made it off to the new area. Welcome everybody, as we get a very uncomfortable crotch shot to the residence. Courtyard here, not really much we can do here. Alright, Inventory. And there's like plenty of blue herbs, because the game gives you like 3 blue herbs here in case you get poisoned and stuff. And what's the best part is over here is a save room. Good despite wanting to revisit an old PS1 game. Well, how come? I mean, it's always good to like revisit old games that you like, I suppose. Unless it's a game you don't like. Alright. Put this here. Probably might need the fuel canteen later, but for now we're not gonna need the crank. We are gonna need the shotgun, and we're gonna take some of the items that are here just to get out of the way. Flash grenades. And ink ribbons. Oh, it's a rare game. I don't really know that many rare games for PS1. Let's see. I'm gonna need some bullets. Oh, finding it. It's the issue. Ah. Alright. That should do for now. Actually, no, we're not gonna need any kerosene for the moment. Alright, let me think for a moment on what to do next. I need to think for a moment. Oh yeah, we're gonna get the rest of the blue herbs over here. Fear Effect 2 Retro Helix. Huh. I don't think I've ever actually heard of that game. Alright. Dump off these bits of mixtures, and that'll do. Fear Effect both on games on 4 discs. Oh, yeah. That was the time and area back then where you actually had multiple discs for games. Alright, let me just push this crate over here, because that'll be important. We'll be able to cross here without getting molested by tentacle monsters. And take care of something that I hope people don't have arachnophobia. If you guys have arachnophobia, you might want to look away for a bit. There is a giant friggin' spider right in our face right here. And I missed! Holy crap, that took a lot of hits. Then again, I missed one of them, because I'm dumb. Alright, green herb. Light this baby up. There we go. Strange silhouette hovers a reddish light. Could it have some kind of meaning? Oh, it's red, not orange. This cover being weird. Oh. And then the, what the? Oh yeah, that thing does that. Also, there's this random pin-up picture here. Not sure if that's supposed to be anyone. Let me just exit the room and then re-enter, because I don't really want to get touched by that nasty pus that's coming out of that spider. Because that pus poisons, and poison I don't really feel like dealing with. And it damages me as well. We still got like about less than 30 minutes before the stream is over and I have to call it a night. Alright. 2 herbs, and there's some items that I have to pick up, so I need to dump off stuff. I can dump off the herbs, and I can dump off the handgun ammo. And I should be able to pick up everything that's in there. Alright. I don't need the bullets for now. Oh man, I'm low on shotgun shells. I am really low on shotgun shells. Then again, we don't get the grenade launcher, I think. That's why I'm low on ammo. At least we got plenty of bullets for the pistol, still. It just makes me feel comfortable having enough shotgun shells. When I'm low on shotgun shells, that's when I start to get a little bit antsy. Something like this one, then this two, and then this one, like disc swapping. Oh yeah, a lot of disc swapping in games back then. Oh, speak of the devil, some shotgun shells. Should be a few things here, I think. Light this baby up. Green light. Don't think I've ever investigated this. Brass lighter coated with gold. Alright. First aid box, and then lastly, red book. Don't think that spider ever jumps off from there. If it does, that would be a problem. I think the spider just stays up there. Also, look at that butt. I'm sorry, everyone. Just look at that butt. That is a nice butt. Strange orange light, yada yada yada, and then it's the puzzle for here. 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. 3, 5, and 6. Okay. I remember that. Seems significant about the order. Yeah, usually disc games for those usually go in order, like put disc 1 in, then put disc 2, and etc. I think that's the first time I've ever heard of out of order, like 2, 1, 2, 1, 3, 4, 3, 2, and 4, 2. Yeah, that sounds odd. I'm guessing they only had like certain areas you can only access throughout the discs. Alright, oh yeah, I gotta open the thing to see what's inside. Alright. Alright, put this away. It feels nice to have some shotgun shells again. Put this away, put this here. I don't believe I'm gonna need the shotgun for a little bit. I think I can safely put the shotgun away for now. But I think I will need the kerosene. Or it was characters. Well, that's two. It's, I guess like certain characters will be available in certain areas. The computer processes just, yeah, that's probably more likely. Alright. Anyways, this is probably going to be mostly blind. I'm only, like, trying to remember what happens through Jill's side of the story, not so much from Chris. So I'm not going to really know what's going to be in here. I'm a little worried. Oh, yeah, this little bit. I forgot. You know what, folks? I'm going to take a small little 5-minute break. I'm going to go use the bathroom. I'll be right back. I hope you guys don't mind. I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back. Where were we? Alright, I'm gonna investigate this area. Newspaper lies scattered about. They all seem to be containing articles about stars. That's not suspicious at all. Door's locked. Gallery. I'm gonna need a key for that. Don't know if there's anything else here. Can I go this way? No, it's just an invisible wall, right? Yeah, it's just a wall. Now then. No cutscene? That's something was supposed to happen here. What's this? Plant 42 report. 4 days have passed since the accident. The plant at point 42 is growing at an amazing rate. Although there are many unknown aspects about this plant, we know that in comparison with the other groups of plants, the T-virus has had a significantly stronger effect on this one. The T-virus has dramatically morphed its host anatomy as well as its size. It's difficult to imagine its original appearance. Nowhere on Earth will you find anything like it. We also found that plant 42 has two main sources of acquiring its essential nutrients. One source is through its roots. Somehow it has rooted itself down into the basement. Immediately after the accident, a scientist went mad and destroyed the aquarium. Since then, the basement has been like a pool. There is a high possibility that it's one of the chemicals in the water that's promoting the plant 42's rapid growth. However, we have yet to determine the specific chemical. A bubble-like body of the plant 42 has been seen hanging from the ceiling of the first floor. We are sure that it is used the air ducts to reach the first floor. Numerous long tentacles like vines were protruding from the bulb. We believe the vines are the second means of acquiring its nutrients. When the plant 42 senses prey, it uses the tentacle-like vines to capture its prey. After doing so, suckers on the vine drain the prey of its blood. We also have noticed that it has some intelligence. When it captures its prey, or when it's inactive, the vines twine around the door to stop possible intruders. Unfortunately, several of our scientists have already fallen victim to this plant 42. When we've heard the stories of the survivors, they all observe one thing in common. When the uniform petal-like flaps open and reveal its vital innards, it has a tendency to become more aggressive. What is... Let me take a small drink. What witness reported that it was as if it was trying to protect itself. Why it behaves the way it does is still unknown. May 21st, 1998, Henry Saturn. I was only 8 years old at the time. Don't know if there's anything else to get in here. No, there isn't. But there is a door here, and I don't know if there's a bad guy in here. But more than likely there is. Wait, was it blinking? It was. Crusader's vial is broken. What the? Oh, residence key. Number 001 is imprinted. Can't investigate the sink. Or the tub. I think there's gonna be a zombie through here. That's not gonna be fun. Will he follow me through the door? That's the one thing. If he follows me through the door, I'm gonna have more of a fighting chance than if it doesn't. That's the gallery door. Down here, I'm gonna get the shotgun just in case, because I really don't want to be grabbed and stuff. I'm also gonna. Oh, I should have used the key. I actually might need the shotgun, so I'm gonna take it just as a precaution. That should do. Alright, let's go take care of some zombies. And there we go. No further use for this key and discard. What the hell? Some things in here, that's for sure. Oh yeah, that guy committed suicide. That shows signs of it being used. Oh, there's some stuff here. Oh yeah, the self-defense gun! You get it here! I forgot about that. Suicide note. June 22nd, 1998. I had to do it. We ran from those things, but helping each other survive. But Robert started to show the symptoms. I had to do it. Those damn things are pure evil. There was no other way. He would have done the same thing if it were the other way around. After I put him out of his misery, I had to just leave him in the bathroom. Now I'm probably the last one. How could this have happened? I'll never forgive myself for being part of this project. Eventually, they'll get what's coming to me. Oh, I'll get what's coming to me, though. There's no way to escape this nut house. It's just a matter of time now. Everything is set. All I need is a little courage to get it done. Knowing that I'll leave many things undone is regret beyond words. But this is better than just waiting to turn into one of them. Please understand and at least let me end my life as a person. There's a message on the back. Linda, please forgive me. Pretty sad stuff there. Also, there should be some, yeah, handgun ammo. Self-defense gun that fires .22 magnum rounds. Oh, .22. One round has already been fired. We're gonna hold on to this, bookcase with a concern with literature and philosophy. And that should be everything here. Yeah. We're actually gonna save this self-defense gun. This will be very important later on. If I don't get stuck in the thing here. And so I'm gonna put this away. Because I think there might be two items to get in this bathroom. And just to be sure, I'd just rather have the inventory space. Because I know we get one, but I'm not sure if it's two. Alright. And now we gotta go check out the spooky bathroom. If I can just kerosene this guy right off the bat. Toilet paper, they're very discolored. Can't remember if it's here or here. Or a polished mirror. Is it in the toilet? No, it's not in the toilet. Is it right here? No, it's not right here. I think it's in the bathtub itself. A little dirty water and pull the plug. There's something inside the bathtub. There we go, the control room key. That's what I'm looking for. Key for entering the control room. Does it have anything else? No. Oh! There we go. No, he's not dead. Okay, that takes care of him. I don't think, as Crimson Heads, these guys will come through the doors. But I don't think that's ever happened, because I usually just burn them anyway. Since there's like a fresh bucket of kerosene in the safe room. And I don't think that guy falls off, so it should be fine. Alright, now we got this control room key. You actually can go to a new area with it. And how am I doing on time? Not very good, actually. I don't know if I can do everything that I want to do in less than 15 minutes. Maybe. Let's just wing it. Why not? Alright. Okay. Why do I have to go? Well, I got college in the morning. That's why, I got college too. At 12 in the morning. Or midday, I suppose. Gotta get ready for college. Oh, Jesus Christ! I forgot all about you. Let's hope I can get a headshot. Brains! No, I'm not giving you any brains! Haha! Nice! This is why I love the dagger. Because if you get that headshot after sticking in that dagger, you get that defense dagger back for free. Alright, little puzzle here. I think you just have to push this. Luckily, I have to get up at 8 a.m. at least. Ugh. I'll be honest. That's why I prefer to get, like, at least during the day classes, like, past afternoon. And I don't think I can push that down. Because I'm not much of a morning person. It takes a lot of effort for me to get up early. I'm not much of a morning person. Alright. Anyways, we're in a new area now, which is the Aqua Ring. There's a few things we gotta do in here. Let's see, do I push that right away first, or no, I have to do setup first. If we're up to me, I would like to instead of 15 more minutes, I would like to do another 30 more minutes plus, so like 45 more minutes, you know, stream until 11 over here. Don't worry, Luca, there's no grammar Nazis in here that I know of. I'm not much of a grammar Nazi. Although one of my best friends who's from Pennsylvania, he is the biggest grammar Nazi I've ever known. He's also very picky with pronunciation. That's just part of his... I guess how he was raised, I guess. But that's not a bad thing, anyways. Anyways, push this over here, push the box down, and then we got a little path. I think you gotta let it... No, I don't need that stuff here. I wonder if I have the space for this. Free green herb. I don't... I think I need the kerosene for the moment. And you know what? I think, yeah, I'm gonna need some space. I'm gonna get a lot of stuff here, actually. So I better dump off this stuff. Alright. Alright. I'm gonna go dump off some stuff, and then we're gonna take care of a few things in the Aqua Ring, and then I'll probably have to call it a night. I don't think I'm gonna be able to stream Wednesday, but I might be able to stream on Thursday again. if I get the chance. I don't know if I'll... hopefully, I don't think anything should pop up. But Wednesday, I got some stuff I gotta do after class. Alright. Hello, safe room, my old friend. Don't need the fuel canteen, and I don't think I need the shotgun. Not gonna need the shotgun. Alright. And that should be more than enough space for everything we're gonna get in this next area. Also, don't want to go into that little gap there, because bad things happen in that little gap on the side there. Seems like every once in a while the little things bother, so like something about like CPU. I don't know what that means. Alright. Let's go take care of the Aqua Ring. This is a little thing we could do. We could pick up that map, but we don't want to pick it up actually, because something bad will happen. And I don't want to accidentally have it happen. Alright. Oh yeah, headshotted him, of course. I was about to say, I think I might need the kerosene, but I headshotted that zombie. That's why I got the dagger back. Alright. Alright. Make sure I'm able to run the fastest, and this part's not going to be fun. This part is definitely not going to be fun.
Richard!
How did you get here, Richard?
Chris, stop!
No! No, Richard! Goddamn sharks! Fuck you, Jaws, you asshole!
Richard!
I hate you, Jaws. I hate Jaws. Jaws is a jerk. Nobody likes Jaws. Killed Richard, that bastard. Okay, we need to run. We need to run like there's not a shark following us. No further use for this key and discard. Nobody likes sharks. Sharks are just evil. They are the meanest creatures on Earth. Okay, warning light indicates that there's an emergency. I don't think there's anything up here. They have to actually go down here. I want to make sure I pick everything up first before I do what must be done. Caution, in case of drop in oil pressure, open valve number 3. Alright. And here's a little map of the Aqua Ring. 2 floors of the Aqua Ring. Alright. Now there should be a few things we can get here before I do what must be done in this area. It should be nearby here. So we gotta probably figure out what's causing that little high encoding CPU usage thing. And we get a mixture of 2 green herbs inside. Alright, and I think that should be everything to collect there. Yes. Alright! It's go time. Controls for the main thing. Everything seems to be walking in proper order. Emergency error has been displayed. Something appears to have gone wrong while the water was being drained. There's a switch to drain the water, and yeah. And Jaws is a jerk.
Unknown source of pressure detected. Locking all doors to achieve maximum safety.
Okay, what do I do first? Pressure seal this locks, release the safety. Safety mechanism for the pressure seal has been released. Okay, this shouldn't be too hard. If I get it right, Control the lever for the pressure seal. Pull. There we go.
Reaching 30% of pressure.
Oil pressure lost. Alright. Oh god, Jaws! Don't do that, Jaws. Switches here, control the valves, press number 3. There we go. Gotta hurry before that thing gets to 100%, otherwise we're done for. Alright. I should have plenty of time. Unless the game wants to be rude like that.
Activate emergency drainage system immediately.
I think that should be it. Oh, hey, I gotta do this. There we go. The water has been completely drained. Alright! Now we can actually explore the Aqua Ring. Huzzah, huzzah, huzzah. And now Jaws is SOL, a bastard. That's what you get for killing Richard, you stupid shark. Alright, should be some items here to get. Shotgun shells. Dynamite soaked beyond use. Okay, the shotgun shells are the only thing you can get there. Don't want to forget what's over here, too. Oh yeah, definitely don't want to forget this. Mwah, mwah. Magnum rounds. So beautiful. That should be the only thing there. Yeah. Alright, we're not actually done with this area just yet. I'm just gonna go unlock this door. One of those doors that's locked from the other side. I think I should have enough inventory space for... for the thing. I think there's only one item to get left. Alright. Alright. Anyways, the last little bit of the Aqua Ring. Stupid Jaws. Wait, what was that? What was that? Oh, you do get Richard's shotgun. I didn't know you actually get Richard's shotgun. Oh man, that changes everything. I need to go back then. I need to go dump off some stuff then. Alright. I honestly didn't think you could get Richard's shotgun as Chris. Because I know you can get it as Jill. Double shotgun chime? Oh, I wish. I wish you could dual wield shotguns. That would be the best thing on earth. Unfortunately, you can't. Richard's shotgun, I think, is a little bit stronger than the regular shotgun, and it holds 10 extra bullets. June, are you still there, man? Can you tell me if the only difference between the two shotguns is that Richard's shotgun does a little bit more damage and has the 10 ammo capacity? Because I think strength-wise they're about the same, but I'm pretty sure the assault shotgun is a little bit stronger. Plus it has the extra ammo slots. Yeah. We're gonna use the assault shotgun instead of the regular shotgun now. Which means I'm gonna have to use the last bits of the regular shotgun. But for now, we're just gonna put it away. It'll have its time to shine a little bit later. Assault shotgun is a bit stronger and has more range. Yeah, I knew it was a little bit better than the regular shotgun. Okay, that only has 4 shells left in it. I'm gonna put that magnum there. And I'll put the herb in here. And it has a crimper pump. Oh yeah, it does reload a little bit faster. Pretty sure too. Gotta love those pump action shotguns. Alright, we got everything we need. We dumped off everything we needed. Just gotta get that one last item. Take a quick drink. Alright. Go back downstairs. Alright. Alright, now that we've done everything here, all we have to do is just get one last item downstairs. And then we'll call it a night for this set of Resident Evil. Alright. Alright. Gotta go back to where those stupid sharks are. Frickin' Jaws. Nobody likes Jaws. Alright. Hello, Illegal Magic. Welcome to the stream. Although you came a little bit late, because I'm getting close to winding it down for the night. Alright. Not sure if you have to check here. Generation unit for the water flow. Pull the lever. Make sure you have to do this first. Whoa. Alright, I think you have to pull it up first, then investigate. Water flow crochet doesn't have any power. It was making the berserker sounds. I thought I did it right. Oh. Oh, this better late than ever, I suppose. Oh. Okay, that did that then. Frickin' Jaws. Okay, I'm not supposed to push it like that. I need to turn off the power. Turn this off. And then we push it, right? There we go. So long, me Bowser! Shark got what it deserved. Nice achievement, deep sixed. Alright, and I think it should be safe to jump into water now. Residence key. Anyone in the mood for some shark burgers? And that stupid Nautilus is dead. And you know what? Maybe a waste of a bullet? I don't like you, shark. I missed. Did I miss? No. Wasted a bullet, but hey, shark got what it deserved. Alright. Gallery isn't printed on it. And now we got a gallery key. You know, I wouldn't know what a shark burger tastes like, but probably pretty good. Oh, then again, I'm not a big seafood person. Alright. Now we got that gallery key, well, I can actually use it in the next area of the residence. Which we can unlock a door, and then that'll actually be it for tonight. Alright, let's go take that gallery key and put it to good use. There we go. Discard. And that'll do it for tonight, actually, for me. It's getting a bit late. It's already 10:35 over here, California time. But, yeah, that'll do it for tonight's stream of Resident Evil HD. I hope you guys enjoyed the stream as much as I enjoyed playing it. But, yeah, it's time for me to unfortunately call it a night. Let's just go quickly save. Thank you, Luca. Be sure to, if you haven't already, if you want, you know, you can hit the old follow button and you'll be able to know when I go live again. But I'll probably go back live on Thursday this week. Probably need the, just want to do some last minute prep before I call it a night. I don't need this, but... You just got here? Well, you should be able to get the stream highlight. Or, like, the stream should be saved in the log or something. You can rewatch it from there. You can rewatch the previous thing. I'm going to post both the first stream for Chris's story and the second stream, which I'm doing right now. I'll post those up in my YouTube channel, which should be in the little description down there. But yeah, I got to get going, unfortunately. Thank you so much, everyone who enjoyed and joined up. But that'll do it for me tonight. Alright. Well, that'll take care of tonight's stream. I hope you guys enjoy, and I'll see you guys next time. Later, folks. Have a good night.